his traumatized of jewelry, the diamond of the Orient swept over the world after 90 years travel. And then this is our executive summary. As you can see that we will first introduce the contribution of the case. Chow Tai Fook, which is an originally recognized local Hong Kong brand, sold after 90 years of drive. And it has provided insight for three stakeholders specifically. First, the staff's company can learn from Chow Tai Fook localized way to tackle with all those challenges and problems. Secondly, the local or the foreign competitors can have an insight on their O2O operating model. Thirdly, the readers and you guys can have a fuller picture of the current luxury industry prospects and opportunities and challenges. And then after our investigation, we found out that Chow Tai Fook is focusing on these five values, which are practice, people, customers, community, and environment. Due to that, Chow Tai Fook has performed very well, and then you can see from this number, they have over 1.6 million members and over 2,000 POS, which refers to the retail store all over the world. And then let's take a look on its worldwide coverage. It has covered over 9 countries, as you can see, mainly covered in Asian markets such as South Korea and then mainland China. And then their achievements is very well performance. You can see that from this picture, and they have gained the achievement in terms of these 6 aspects. And then I will pass the time to my teammate to talk about the financial performance.
So thank you, Sharon. So as you can see, the business is enjoying its peak in the 2014 and sales in terms of sales revenue and gross profit. And then soon after, in the next year, it actually has been experiencing a continuous drop in the sales revenue. And the POS network is actually keeps expanding. So let's take a look at the past year financial results. It's actually there is a slight change in 2017, which is there is a 6% growth in the profit for the year. This implies that there is actually a drop in operating expenses, which actually set off the negative impact of the drop in sales revenue. And as you can see in the detailed log, actually the second half year in 2017, there is a growth in quarterly sales when compared with the same period in 2016. And according to a well-known investment bank corporation, Goldman Sachs, it actually has analyzed the Chow Tai Fook financials and expected that in 2018 there will be around 6% growth in sales revenue in China or in other Asian markets. So when we take a deeper look in the ratios and financials, it's not hard to notice that actually most of the revenue comes from mainland China. So may I now pass the time to my teammate to talk about the critical moments of Chow Tai Fook.
And for the critical moments, since you can see that Chow Tai Fook has faced over 10 challenges within 2 decades, and we would like to pick 2 critical moments for a further discussion. And in 2008, there was a global financial crisis and evolving consumer behavior and the rise of Pandora. And also in 2016, there was an outbreak of H7N9 and the anti-corruption in China. This effect is very large due to the largely decreased tourism rate as well as the Chow Tai Fook profits. And then Chow Tai Fook has launched 3 approaches to deal with this problem, such as expansion. First, the expansion of business model, digitalization, and the injection of youth elements. First, for the expansion of business model, you can see that Chow Tai Fook has a risky but active corporate expansion. In 2014, Chow Tai Fook has launched 2 casinos in Seoul, Korea and Vietnam, and it has increased the customer base of the company by cross-selling the products to the new customers. Also, for the real estate aspect, Chow Tai Fook has built the office building in China, such as Guangzhou, who built the Chow Tai Fook Finance Center, and it has leveraged the risk of facing downturn in the jewelry market has been shared. And you can see from this histogram that the successful of this strategy in referring to this increasing progress from 2018 to 2014. Apart from that, Chow has also enhanced its vertically verbal integration and lateral expansion. By appearing of three diamonds, mines, and pass on fire, it ensured a stable supply of the raw materials and opened a gateway to the Western countries. Also, Chow has also excavated an Chow Academy in 2015, which provides lots of online courses and on-the-job trainings. And then it aims to develop the professional employees and support the sustainable goals to its business. Apart from that, Chow has also launched a new brand, which is called the T-Mart, and you can see it, which is his logo on this photo. And then T-Mart is integrated with 4C, 4T, and nano inscription technology, which contributed 8% in Asian markets. It indicates the effectiveness of this strategy in this area. And all in all, vertically integrated business model is a key to success for Chow Tai.
So, to avoid lagging behind in the art of digitization, Chow Tai attempted to digitize its services. So, its digitization history actually began in early 20s with its first launch of the mobile application for its VIP members, and together with the loyalty membership program, it actually successfully creates a strong customer bonding with its buyers. And also, until now, there are already over 1.5 million members accumulated for the program, and actually 30% of them usually make frequent repurchase. And then, understanding the appropriate customer behavior, Chow Tai Fook also set up some online store and physical stores to secure markets for its output to complete its vertical integration model. So you can see the online store have achieved such remarkable results. And what I want to highlight is the Tmall.com. It's really a smart step for Chow Tai Fook to take in order to gain the benefits and the reputation and competitive advantages of Alibaba, which is the parent company of Tmall.com. And also, this is the smartest plan. It's actually an extension of the collaboration with different famous Chinese brands. Its aim is to penetrate into people's daily lifestyle and through the smartphone. And the RFID technology is actually a small gadget to be installed in the drone display tray, and so that to collect data from customer, and it actually replaced the old surveying method of collecting data in order to save time. And then the data collector will use to be generate analysts to for better sales strategies, and also at the same time, stock taking function is also performed. And then this O2O business model creates the all-round shopping experience for customers. So customers can actually get the latest promotion news and pre-order products and pay for their products online from Chow Tai Fook website. And then the products will be directly delivered to their home. And then they will have to fill in a customer feedback and evaluation form for Chow Tai Fook to recommend handle their customer relationship management, which is CRM. And so you may wonder why Chow Tai Fook is so proud of its O2O business model, because O2O is not a new term to the business world. But actually, when we imagine Chow Tai Fook is not actually delivering like fast fashion or clothes or food only. It's actually delivering some luxurious and jewelries, which can actually cost up to like millions or thousands of dollars. So every procedure in the model is actually have to be really meticulous and really complicated. And so when it comes to O2O, I would definitely say Chow Tai Fook as a leader in the market. Then the job will understand that it's actually important to integrate the offerings through injection of group elements and cultural elements, because round expansion is one of the most important part of them. And so they start to plan the Western and Eastern culture through some series of jewelries, for example, the perfect one wedding series. And they also, in order to attract the younger generation, they also make some microfilms as advertisement, which convey a message that Chow Tai Fook is not only selling jewelry, but also they are selling diversity, respect of culture, and love and romance. And using the influence of KOL celebrities like TV, and also the trendy kind of characters actually successfully make Chow Tai Fook with the words fashionable and trendy, and it successfully attract many young people. So let's, after all these strategies, let's take a look at the current situation of Chow Tai Fook for small animals. So it's, of course, as its internal strength, for example, its long history of Chow Tai Fook as its linking sales network around the world. And also, the extensive business operation model also allows it to diversify its business risk and increase source of revenues. So it also has its own drawbacks. For example, its offerings usually are criticized as lack of recognition from young generations because of the positioning of time-honored brand. And there are also opportunities for them. For example, customers nowadays are becoming more picky and choosy and more sophisticated. So this actually gives an opportunity for Chow Tai Fook to expand their business because they always highlight and focus their quality and transparency on product production of jewelry. And for external client, the renminbi fluctuation and the uncertain global economy is definitely curtailing the purchasing power of people. An emergence of Thai and Indian drone industry, which actually adopt the low-price strategy as a gimmick, also make a devastation to Chow Tai Fook. And in the future, we will recommend Chow Tai Fook to take these four strategies. First of all, to continue expansion in China, for example, to conquer the luxury market, especially in the first-tier cities in China. And second is to always stay online through a multi-level to a business model. Then the third one is to offer exclusive after-sales services and to launch a budget outlet to cater different needs of different customers, for example, especially the price-sensitive ones. So we are now pass the time to my teammate for the success factors.
And for the success factor, as you can see, the Chow Tai Fook success is attributed to various success factors. And we would like to separate it into seven factors. As you can see, the Chow Tai Fook adds currently to the market by collaborating with different KOLs and celebrities such as Mimi Ho and Jason Gan. And you can see that their point of sale has been everywhere and online. And they can use the brand C and the connection between the close connection of mainland China and Hong Kong. They can enjoy the benefits between them. And then how to be self-sufficient? They can enjoy it due to their vertically integrated business model. And then due to the free information access to the customer, they can make a comparison between among the brands. Therefore, their integrated business model, which has included the conglomerate, the expansion, has diversified its business progress into the real estate and the casino industry. They will always go back to the Chinese roots by featuring different Chinese branding cultures. And then I would pass the time to Rannia to talk about the conclusion.
So instead of borrowing summary of listing all the items we have mentioned just now, I would rather to conclude in an interesting way. Actually, the Chow Tai Fook story of Chow Tai Fook is actually an inspiring story for all the students on their future career path. For example, we would suggest them to stay hungry and stay foolish as Chow Tai Fook, because Chow Tai Fook, despite its long, extensive sales network and base in mainland China, is always staying humble and learning with partners and competitors like Pandora. And also, dare to be a pioneer in the market. For example, Chow Tai Fook will never lose the impact of its sales strategies in advance. So, as a student, I would suggest them always to dare to try different fields in the business or different subjects to explore their own interests. And last but not least, is don't hurry, because you know, success always takes time. Like for a large brand like Chow Tai Fook, it's actually took 19 years of time to succeed. So, you never know what you will get in the future. So, you will actually find your own way after all. So, don't just get bothered by worrying the ideal job. If you can find the ideal job, you can succeed in the future. So, and last but not least, let's keep the Chow Tai Fook tales always in our mind to remind us. So, this is the end of our presentation. We welcome any questions and feel free to ask.
You mentioned about the success factors such as Guanxi connection, right? What kind of Guanxi you guys, the company used to make success?
this question, and you can refer to this picture. And about the Guanxi and the connection, China between back then, between the coast.
Can you speak slowly?
Due to the close connection between mainland China and Hong Kong, they can enjoy the benefits under SIPA, which is agreed in 2006 between mainland China and Hong Kong, such as tax-free in Hong Kong, and then they can transport some of their luxury goods, such as gold, necklace, or breakfast free with tax-free.
Presenter will be